I'm playing like shit now for some reason. I don't know why. Too much talk. So. That kind of happened to Rana Banana in H2. So many people think Cryphon holds the H2 world records and Rana is beating all of them. Oh, okay. I'm not sure what happened there. Is there a... Fear the man that finished Ninja Gaiden Black 10,000 times. I quite like that one. What's up, B-Trans? I had a question. Can you look at chat? Oh, sorry. Was that the chat? Was that the question you just answered? Yeah. The question I just answered. Sorry. Yeah. But yeah, and it's... I mean, it feels like there was a string of that lately. I was talking about TV, actually, with a friend a while ago. And she mentioned that House of Cards is really good. And I've not seen House of Cards. And it's funny. As someone who, like, doesn't have Netflix, I don't really watch a lot of TV. I heard of House of Cards when all that Kevin Spacey stuff happened. Probably longer ago than I remember now. And then, you know, there were people like, oh, this spoils House of Cards for me. And I think, yeah, I understand that, but, I mean, like, where do you draw the line on that stuff? There's another example of that. You know, if someone has to be, like, a saint before anything they can do, anything they, like, do be considered good, then... I mean, you know, that's going to seriously lower the amount of people that people can look up to, for one. Okay, now don't get shot here. Alright, so we've got three captains. Oh, god damn it, Ryu. Okay, nice. Should have one more Grenadier, I think. Yep. Wait for this guy to stand up. Separate the art from the artist, yeah. Yeah, because I've heard House of Cards is amazing, but... I mean, like, I'm not going to not watch House of Cards, because, and again, I don't really follow media and all that enough to really know what happened with all that shit, so, I kind of always take that stuff with a pinch of salt. That was close. So they think being an alcoholic themselves will make them right, like Bukowski. Yeah, I mean, that's a very good point, actually, Angel, yeah. Like, it's, you know, it can go the other way, too. You know, like, if I told you the secret to being good at NG was, like, eat cheesecake every day and don't exercise, and then someone did that, I was like, well, JTB said to get good at NG, you gotta not exercise and eat cheesecake every day, and I got really fat. It's his fault. It's like, well, you could have just not listened to me. And also realized that that's bad advice. An extraneous example, I agree, but the principle, I feel like, is the same. I would actually argue the opposite is right, to be honest. I feel like there's a... I think lately, people have gotten more kind of open to this, but when it comes to games, I feel like if you feel good in your body, like, if you feel healthy, like, your mind is better and you play better. When I was playing fighting games, like, there was a time where I wasn't really being that healthy. I wasn't really taking care of myself all that much because I just wanted to play and lab. You know, all I wanted to do was play fighting games. But then when I kind of thought, okay, no, you need to get back on track and, you know, start exercising again, start eating properly again, I played much better, you know? So I feel like there is definitely a mind-body link there when it comes to games. Like, if you feel good, you will play good. If you feel like crap, you probably won't play as good. And again, there are exceptions to that. My two cents. Okay, so I am actually going to chain essence to these guys because these guys can be Charlies. Give me a blue. Thank you. I really thought that'd kill him. Crap. There's an example of fucking hell. I'm gonna blame JTB for me being fat, Boxstrat. I wouldn't say you're fat, Jolly. not say that. You just built. You just built like an old-fashioned dude. You just well built. Can you do the rope skip on Sigma or no? Oh, what, in Chapter 3? Oh, I've never tried it. I would assume so. As long as you're fast enough. But I've not actually tried it. But yeah, you could skip kills there, yeah. That's true. You... Okay, now, hang on a minute. I could chain essence to this and get UTs here. I don't need it. Yeah, I don't need it, though, so... See you, lads. And not to get off on another tangent, but I do feel like the word fat has become kind of insane in this day and age. That's something where women definitely get a raw deal. Like, a woman can be, like, a size 10. And like, oh, they're fat. It's like, no, they're really not. Like, that word meant something very different again when I was younger. Like, someone had to be, you know, pretty large to be called that. And now I feel like, you know, you can just not conform to, like, whatever height, weight you're supposed to be and, like, automatically, like, oh, well, they're fat. It's like, whatever, man. Again, get off online, you know? There is fat and there is chubby. There's also thick. And, you know, not to give too much away about me, but I don't mind that. You know? Just saying. Just saying. You could say overweight. That's true. Yep. Then there's Gal Gadot. Yep. Yeah, but, yeah. Then there's, like, literal goddesses. Yeah, that's true. That's a good point. Although, I mean, Gal Gadot, like, she's very pretty, but, like, she's not thick. She's many things, but she's not thick. She's not thick. She's not thick. You know? I like thick girls. If that wasn't obvious. Slim girls are the better. I mean, honestly, Jolly, like, women, I think, they're like ice cream, man. There's so many flavors. You know? You cheeky little bastard. You see that guy? Trying to blim in. He was gonna up slash me there. Okay, that's chapter 4 done. Yeah, they're like ice cream. There's so many flavors, and they're all good. So, whatever flicks your switch. Remember the time women didn't like to have big butts? Oh yeah, I remember that, Miles. Man, that's. I feel like you're going back into like a different time. But yeah. You go back and watch older movies. Okay, I was thinking about this film the other day because it's a great film. If you haven't seen The Long Kiss Goodnight, Gina Davis and Samuel L. Jackson, go watch it and thank me later. Because it's a fucking brilliant movie. But there's a line in that film, related to the plot, I won't spoil the plot, but Gina Davis, also shout out to Gina Davis, mentions about her character's big ass in like a real negative term. You know, like, oh man, I've got a massive ass. Like, this is horrible. Now... Women get ripped on if they don't have a big bum by other women more often than not, which is kind of bad.